Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is part two of my fun finds on Temu for my classroom. So I'm gonna try to go through this stuff pretty quickly. I did get too much. I will admit, when you see this, you're gonna be like, girl, how much would you spend? I just tackle this with every coupon they send me, and I do like a little $30, $40 here. And you know, I have really slowed down on my other shopping. So I will say I do spend a lot of time in my classroom, but it is something that brings me joy, and I, you know, I just like to provide a lot of different opportunities. I really do talk to the kiddos about how to take care of things, so that I'm hoping that these things do last quite a bit of time. However, I did buy them on Temu, so I do not know the quality until we get in there. So let's just start with, like I said, the thing in my thumbnail. So one of the things that I want to do is mix my morning routine into a variety of like little reviews of maybe like the math lesson from the day before, or a vocab lesson, or a spelling list, but also some hands-on activities. I relied a little heavily on my Chromebook time for morning work last year. We just had so many different resources, and that was a perfect time for me to implement that with my kiddos. But I felt like then, after a few months, they were not wanting to use the resources and wanting to like explore on the internet a little bit. And so I felt like it was just too much time. Like if I had reined that in a little bit, then they would only be focused on those things that I wanted them to. So we just spent a lot of time back and forth talking about like where they should be and what they should be doing and things like that. So I'm restructuring this year. I'm explaining this way too much. And so I bought some items from Temu that looked like fun soft starts, which is like a STEM kind of situation where I can give each student or each table a different type of building material or creative material, and they can just go to town with it. So like I'm gonna try to give each of them some type of structured beginning, just so that we're not playing, but like we're building, we're talking about height and weight and things like that. But also I just wanted to create a time for them to be creative. So I found a bunch of different things I'm going to share with you in this video. This is called the Garden Building Set, and it's just, it's like a little, they can start with this little kind of ground and they can build up the flowers. So they can make different designs and different size flowers. We can talk about bigger and smaller and, you know, different petals and things like that. So it comes with building blocks, and it gives you different ideas. Like they can create stuff and keep it. So this set was about, I want to say, this is probably the most expensive set I got, and it was around like $9, but it comes with the different floral pieces as well as this like dirt kind of ground. So I thought I could break this up into a couple of different bins, and then like I said, they get to kind of pick and choose their bins as we go. Let's see, got some other things. Oh, I'll start with these two. I got some posters. I don't know that I'll need to use all of these. They came together, and in each set, there was just something I kind of wanted for either a vocab wall or something like that. This is just a cute alphabet poster, but then these had some good like bossy R, and we can talk about this, and they have some different examples, and it has like a picture and the word so that they could copy that or learn to spell that. Beginning blends. So these are just things I know that we're gonna talk about. Short and long vowels. So we're going to talk about like how they can identify which goes with which word, double letter ending. So this was a really good set. And I know all of these sets were like $3. So if you are a teacher, definitely go look on Temu. You're going to pay that on Teachers Pay Teachers, but then you have to print it yourself, laminate. These are laminated and they're ready to go. This is, digraphs. So just different ones. Like we can talk about like QU and SH, WH, TH. So I don't know. I thought these were good. Hard and soft C and G. Again, these are just second grade lessons that we're going to have to go over. And I like to give a visual. And then I like to, like, this is almost like a little anchor chart they can use. Tricky vowels like O, 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 I. And then the magic E chart. So we can talk about that E at the end. And then vowel team. So I feel like I'm going to get the most use out of this chart, minus maybe the alphabet chart, but we'll see. I do have like a growth mindset alphabet that I like to hang up. But if I need this one, I guess I'll use this one. Let's see. I also got, again, not knowing if I'll need it, but this is an alphabet, another little alphabet, which again, I might use in like a writing center or small group table. these are the different digraphs, then there's blends and vowel sounds. So again, I might put these on a ring and put this in like a center for them to use. Again, for $1 or $2, I would pay more than that to print it myself and then to laminate it. This, I just, again, thought for a wall that I would be able to add these as we go over them, and they would have like an easy resource. So like adjectives, and this tells you what an adjective is, and then some examples, and we've got adverbs, conjunction, interjection, noun, preposition, pronouns, and verbs. And I figured we would start with this and maybe make our own little lists, and then we can add those as well. And then this was just word families like the AD, AM, AN. These are probably things that they did learn in first grade, but I thought that we could find a reference for this. And again, each of these were less than $2 a piece, so I was like, I wouldn't be able to print that myself, so it's a good deal. Okay, some more of the stuff for the soft starts. These are magnet tiles, which these are small, but I might get another set too. These are were just such a hit with my other kiddos, so I thought they're really fun to build. They kind of just magnetize together, and then they actually comes with like a booklet I'll probably keep in there to give them some ideas. Then I got some snowflakes. Again, I'm probably gonna get some of those hashtag blocks from Target, and I'm just gonna get some little bins and then have these for like once you get your first item of the morning. We usually have a good 30 minutes in the morning to fill. Some kids work really fast, some kids work slower, so these will be used a ton this year. A couple of things, I was trying to keep everything together, but I did want to have a calming corner. I had a place in my classroom last year for them to go, but it wasn't like filled with resources. I kind of had like a bucket that they could just pick something from, like a fidget. And so this is really cool. I love this. I wanted one of these. It's that like breathe ball, I call it, so they can like pull it out and put it in, and it's quiet. I always look for quieter fidgets. Some are just louder, and then you've got other kids that are distracted by that, so you kind of like doubled or tripled your need for something. But this could be used, like I said, back of the classroom, and we breathe with it, and it kind of expands in and out, and like it was like a dollar, so I was like, yep, I can afford that. Here's another, these are those snowflake beads. Like I said, just a ton of things like this so that there's a variety and enough for everybody. It's my plan, and they were a really good deal. Against spell the word. So I thought this was really cute, and I do just want to keep some of these things at home and bring them throughout the year so we have new stuff. It's not all going to be new on day one. But these, again, they, you know, they're from Temu, so they say some funny things like this is like learn English. But I thought once we're learning some of these vowel patterns and things, these are all different words, and then they come with different like beads. And so we can just play like a spell the word game, and I just, again, small group thing, $1 or $2. Can't find this stuff at the dollar store. Can't find all this stuff at the Target dollar spot. So I picked up some of it. Some more snowflakes. I feel like that one's going to be a really good one. I wanted these for, I have in my new classroom, a lot of those like borders of where you can stick pins and like hang artwork and stuff. So these are just little push pins, but they're on a little clip. So I'm going to hang those up just to demonstrate some of their work, or it could be a place where we hang our anchor charts, just something easy. And they were really inexpensive. I bought this timer. I like the idea of this timer. This was a timer I kind of used with preschool, and it has like a visual timer. So you can spin the dial and it shows the kiddos how much time they have. So I thought this would be really great for like cleanups and like, oh, you have 5 minutes, and they can see the 5 minutes disappearing. So once it's almost ready to go off, you have less of this blue. I had a huge one, which I might invest in, but I wanted to see if second grade really responded to that. I got these ninja highlighters, and that's just another thing I thought of for small groups. So they have little ninja faces on there, and I thought we could like secretly like spy for words. I don't know. I thought they were really cute for like a dollar. I think I got 2 packs of those. Again, I just look for these little things. I think I'm the sucker. You know, I find the stuff, I have to have it. This is like a lifesaver. This is the best staple remover, especially if you're doing bulletin boards. This was a dollar. They're like $8 for a 2-pack or 3-pack on Amazon, but you just basically scoop under, and I mean, literally doesn't like pull at your paper like that little claw one does. I love that. I've given them away as gifts. This is another thing for my little calm area, and it's just this like sensory. I thought we could kind of use it as a timer. Like they can let it all fall to the one end and then turn it over and watch it. And then like when it's empty, they can start to come back to the class, you know, if they need. It doesn't have to be a specific amount of time, but I just thought it was good to put a cap on it. These I'm going to use for some type of like reading or I don't know. They're just really fun little pointers. They're just little hands with pointers, and I got like 20 of them, but I thought, you know, we could do pointer reading. We could do flashlight reading. I think I have some flashlights coming. Just all the different, like, drop everything and read, because I think in second grade, just exposure and practice is going to get them there. So these were like, I think they were right around a dollar something, like maybe $1.60 for this 5-pack. So I went ahead and got enough for my whole class to have one. That was something I could afford to do a whole class set. This I'm going to use after we get going as like a kindness, like classroom thing. So I'm going to hang a little bit of it. It's a roll of coloring paper, and it's basically a graffiti scroll for children. I'm not going to call it that, but this is just all kinds of animals. And so I'm going to have them like talk about different kind things that they do for each other. And when a student's named, I'm going to have them go color a part of the picture. Just again, celebrating their kindness. So I saw this on TikTok or something and I thought it was a really good idea. This is cool. This was again, something that like I didn't know I needed, a spin lollipop. So again, a quiet fidget, and it's something where they can like, you, let's put it together real quick and just show you. Cause I don't know how to explain it otherwise. You just put this in here like so, and then they can just move these pieces to make like different, you know, they can take their time and they can spin it and make all different designs in here. And it just, it's quiet. So it's like a thing that they can use to calm and be quiet. Yes, please. So I look for different things so that I can change things out. I feel like giving them all of this stuff on day one of school would probably not be wise, but like over time they'll need something new. So I picked it up now to have for later. These, again, I'm just thinking on my small group time. Oh man, drop this everywhere. These are phonics flashcards. So these are just like I can read and master. And there's different sets. So this is short A and this is R blend. So I'm just going to get them over time. I want to say that these were like a couple dollars a piece as well. They're really nice. And then like it gives them like a sentence to read after you go over the words. So I figured I would just use these for small group. And then like I said, building their vocabulary. Here's a few other ones I grabbed. This is like tenses. So past tense of verbs. And this is, what is this one? I'll open it and see. It's like the sticker is right over what the card says that they are. Oh, word problems. Yeah, I just, again, like just different things I can use. So how many legs would 5 chickens and 2 pigs have? So they're going to have to like draw that out. How many socks would 10 boys wear? So just thinking outside of the box and like being able to like write out their own problems and then solve them is definitely going to be something that we work on. Then this is verb tenses. This is idioms. I just figured we'd probably cover that. This is, what is this called? The stickers. See, the stickers are like right over what they are. So I'm like, I can't tell you through the card. Oh, homophone. So like hole and hole. And then it gives them an example. Allowed, like you can go when the light is green. So that's kind of like something that they've been in a car and seen a green light. Or aloud, I told a joke aloud. So I thought for a dollar or two, these would be really good sets to have just to go over and practice. I know you guys, this is so much stuff, but I'm hoping if you are a teacher or just like to see different hauls of things, maybe you find use for some of these things in your own personal life. You have family members and kids that might enjoy these kind of toys. These I cannot wait to use. This I'm going to use for just after I tell directions and we go over it. I'm going to point and I'm going to use these pointers to say like, here we are, this is where we're going type of thing. But they're magnetic arrows. I might need more than just one pack, but I wanted to see the quality. Okay, this box is almost empty. Again, just for that indoor recess time, these are Tic Tac boards and they were like a dollar a piece. So I got 4 of them because I figured I could put those in a box. For a day, we just need, these are sand glass timers. So they have different amounts of time on them. This was expensive. This was like 10 bucks. That's not expensive, but like one of the more expensive items, but I could see so many uses for this. So like it gives me a 5 minute timer, 10, 20. So 10 minutes, let's see, 15 minutes. So I figure if I need these types of things, this is just a 1 minute timer. So if I need this type of thing where this maybe a timer with a beep, 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 it might trigger some children and they need a quiet timer, I'm going to have them covered. So it was something that like I put in my cart a billion times and took out. I grabbed a couple more different things for the STEM bins. This is balancing chairs. I kind of think I need another one of these, but it's 24 chairs and they have to figure out different ways to balance a certain number of them and not knock them over. It might even just be like an indoor recess game. And then this one is topple. So you're going to probably play a game, I think, against somebody and then see how many you can stack before the board falls over. Again, if this is going to be distracting for morning work STEM time, then I would use these for like indoor recess time. And I got two of that like topple game. I think I need another one of the balancing chair games. Okay, a few more things. I got these pattern blocks again for STEM morning bins. I do think I have some bins coming too. I got this Tetris game. I love this. I actually think I need another one of these too. I didn't order too many of any one thing in case I was like, don't love the quality, but this is basically they get different parts and then they just kind of figure out how to build and keep it from hitting the top before they've used up all their pieces. So I just think that's so neat. And again, I can use it for either the STEM time or indoor recess. It becomes real when indoor recess is like a week long. This is Sightword SWAT. It may be a little young for my kiddos, but I just thought I might have some ELL kiddos or just, you know, some kiddos that might be at a lower reading level. And we need to start with sight words and just remind them of those words because they need that fluency to read. Or it could just be a fun game that I can put into like an early finisher or a may do type of thing. But I loved this and I had multiplication SWAT for my third graders and they really loved it. So I thought I would get this one and maybe find like an addition or subtraction game. But yeah, I think for the most part, that's everything that I ordered from Temu for my classroom. So I'm going to get this cleaned up and then I'll probably do one more part with my Amazon finds. So let me know down below. Do you guys do the Temu thing? Are you not interested? If you are a teacher, have you tried some of these in your classroom? Like, do they last? What's the quality? Like, give me the details because I need to know. And then I do have some really fun things, I think, for myself that I picked up from Temu as well. So I'm just kind of breaking these up so they're not super long, but yeah, I can't wait to get some of these things in my classroom and get use out of them. And like I said, I try not to just buy to buy. Like I really try to have a purpose for everything. Some of these things I might have to wait. And like I said, just bring them in slowly, introduce them, show them how to use them, and then we go from there. But also I do not love all this clutter in my house. So it's gonna help me slow down because now I have stuff everywhere. I don't know what to do. But thank you so much for watching. I will see you in a video very soon. Take care. Bye.